So we have seen a nice algorithm that is called a sweepline algorithm for filtering the starting time of the activities. The question you may ask is, how do we prune the ending time of the activities? And what I would like to convince you with is that filtering the starting time of the activities and pruning the ending time of the activities is really a symmetrical problem. And so when you will implement the sweepline algorithm inside your solver, your mini CP solver, you want to avoid code duplication. And so you don't want to reproduce a pretty similar code for filtering the starting time and the ending time of the activities. And so the question is, how do we avoid duplicating the code or creating code that is quite similar? One implementation trick that I use in practice is the mirroring of the activities. And so what I do is this, is that for every activity I create a mirror of the activity. It's a kind of view of the activity, which is symmetrical with respect to time zero. And so the starting time of this mirror activity will be exactly the same as the ending minus the ending time of this one. Okay? And the ending time of this one is exactly the same as minus the starting time of this one. So when you post the cumulative constraint, when you will post it, I will have here an additional field in my constructor, which is, do I post the mirror of the constraint or not? And if the post mirror is true, and by default you see that it's true, if you call it with nothing, it's true, I will post here a new cumulative constraint on the mirroring of the starting times, and I will post it and I will set it to false to say that next time you don't do it. And so if you post a cumulative constraint, actually I will post two cumulative constraints for you, because behind the scene I will also post a cumulative constraint on the mirroring activities. And this allows me to only prune the starting time of the activities, because I know that by the mirroring trick I will also prune the ending times. Okay, and again, what you do here, this is a view. Okay, this is really a view. You don't really create a new variable for this. So it's very efficient to implement it like this. What you will do during the exercise session is that you will implement the cumulative constraint. So you will build the profile. You will check that it does not exceed the capacity, and then you will prune the starting time. So this is what you will do this afternoon during the practical session.